polar coordinates and Cartesian coordinates. Some students Cartesian coordinates rectangular coordinates system. The Cartesian coordinates or the rectangular one, the one that we are using, the x-axis and the y-axis and the origin here. And for example, if you move the point 3 and 2, so you lie in the first quadrant and hit it the point 3 and 2. This is the x-coordinates and this is the y-coordinates. But for the polar coordinates, it's the system that we are using angles. The system of using angles or circles in it, for example. This is the first circle with radius 1, passing through the points 1, 1, negative 1, and negative 1. This circle is with the same center origin, but its radius is 2, so 2, 2, 2. So for example, if I have a point here, this point is represented by radius and angle. Radius, it means that second circle, and angle, the angle that represented between the x-axis and the point or the radius of the circle here. So for example, if this angle is 30, so this point represented by 2 and 30. So the polar coordinates is r and theta, but the rectangular coordinates is x and y. First, how we can change or how we can convert from polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates, from r and theta to x and y. X is equal r cosine the angle, and y is equal r sine the angle. For example, I have the point root 2 and pi over 4. R root 2 is the radius and pi over 4 is the angle. And I wanted to find the Cartesian coordinates. The Cartesian coordinates, which is x and y. So x is equal root 2 cosine pi over 4 and y is root 2 sine pi over 4. If you don't know, pi over 4 is 180 over 4, which is 45. So this one is root 2 cosine 45, which is equal to 2 multiply root 2 over 2, which is equal to 1. And this one is root 2 sine 45, and the value also of sine 45 is root 2 over 2, so the answer is going to be 1. So the point is 1 and 1. To convert from x and y to Cartesian, we are using that r is equal root of x squared plus y squared, and theta is inverse of the tan of y over x. Mainly, if you represent a point here on a circle, this one will represent the radius, and this value is x, and that value is y. And if the angle is here, this is opposite, and this is adjacent, so it's going to be tan. So this is x and this is y, and you want to find r first. R will be root of root 3 squared plus 1 squared, which is equal root of 3 plus 1, which is equal root of 4, which is equal to 2. So this is 2. And you want to find the angle, it's inverse of y, which is 1 over root 3. The only angle it's inverse is 1 over root 3 is the angle 30. So the polar 4 is 2 and 30 degrees. In case of you have two magnitudes of z1 and z2, z is equal to 3 cosine pi plus I sine pi, and z2, 2 cosine pi over 2 plus I sine pi over 2, and you wanted to find the product. We found the product by multiplying 3 and 2. We multiply 3 and 2, which is equal to 6. Then we are adding the angles. So cosine pi plus pi over 2 plus sine pi sine pi plus pi over 2, which is equal 6 cosine 3 over 2 pi plus I sine 3 over 2 pi. In case of you want to find the division operation between Z1 and Z2, we start by dividing 3 and 2. And then we are subtracting the angles. We are subtracting the angles. So in case of multiplication, we are adding the angles, but in case of division, we are subtracting the angles. So in case of multiplication, we are adding, but in case of division, we are subtracting. So it's going to be 3 over 2 cosine pi over 2 plus I sine pi over 2. 1 pi, by the way, if you want to consider it as 1 pi, so 1 minus half is half, and 1 plus half is 3 over 2. Finally, how can we use the Moore theorem to find the value of Z1 squared? Z1 squared. What is Z? It's a 3 cosine pi plus I sine pi. This value is a squaring. First, we start by squaring the 3, but for the angles, we multiply I the power, which is 2. So 3 to the power of 2 is 9, and cosine pi multiplied by 2, and I sine pi multiplied by 2 is 2 pi. In case of this power 3 or 4, I'm going to make it 3 to the power of 3 or 4, but the angle is multiplied by the power. Thank you.